Hello beautiful people. In today's episode, we're gonna ask the question, am I happy in my relationship? Being happy in a relationship is hard. It requires work from yourself and it requires work from your partner. And sometimes it's the kind of work you just don't want to do. It's the kind of introspection you wish you didn't have to do to be happy. But truth is, you need to do those things to be able to find your happy place within the relationship. And the challenge is that it's not just you, but also your partner. And that makes the entire exercise really hard. Because not only do you depend on yourself for your happiness, but you now depend on someone else for it. The first aspect of it is understanding what makes you happy. It doesn't matter what people do. If you don't know what makes you happy, you will never be able to reciprocate whatever emotion or whatever effort or whatever time is being spent towards you. If you know what you enjoy, if you know what you like, if you know what makes you happy, that means it's something you can share with someone else to help them make you happy. Someone is not supposed to guess what makes you happy. You're supposed to share it with them so that they can use their resources to make you happy. The first part of any discussion about it is to ask yourself, do I know what makes me happy? If you do, then the following is going to be easier. If you don't, the first step would be to understand what makes you happy. Is it doing activities together? Is it spending time together? Is it finding the person you want once you go home? Is it maybe working with them in certain cases? Knowing that, knowing what brings you balance is basically important, because what brings you balance has a chance to bring you happiness. What doesn't bring you balance will not bring you happiness. Not for the long run, and it will come at a great cost. Now, when we talk about balance, that's pretty much the next step. Is the relationship in balance? And what does that mean? So being happy in a relationship is not necessarily just about smiling all the time, but it's about enjoying the relationship itself. So when we talk about balance, there is the easy concept of who's supporting who and in what condition. Is there an exchange between partners? You know, do you give something to your partner and does your partner give you something back? When times are hard, can you lean on them or not? For a relationship to be balanced, for you to be able to find that happiness, you need to be able to give and take at the same time from your partner, and they have to be able to do the same. Now, it doesn't necessarily need to be a 50-50% ratio. It can be whatever pleases both parties in the situation. But there should be an understanding of your needs and their needs, and they should have the same thing. And a section of those needs should be met by your partner. And that equilibrium is quite important. This is why understanding the things that you want your partner to bring to the table is important. Because if you know them, you can express them and you can figure out if your partner is bringing them. And in exchange for those things, I know it sounds a bit cold, but you should be able to do the same thing for your partner. In reality, it is an exchange of, you know, time and effort towards one another. If this is in balance, then that's a very good step. Then there is an intellectual component to being in a relationship. And when I say that, I talk about what you expect versus what is. You could expect a relationship to have a certain shape and form and a certain exchange and how things should work. But in reality, things could be very, very different. It's not because they are different that it is necessarily bad. Your preconception of a relationship is not necessarily the right one. Your preconception of a relationship may look beautifully in your head, but it also may not be the one that would make you happy. And this is something that you have to check with yourself. Is your preconception the one that you want, or is it just a dream that doesn't really mesh with what you can give and what you can receive? Checking with yourself, you know, do you meet your expectation and are your expectations rational and good is an important step. Because maybe you're going to say, this doesn't meet what I want, but maybe what you want does not exist. You know, it's what you see on TV. Having expectations that are more based in reality that are more about sharing time, sharing space, sharing activities, doing things together and building something together is more realistic. So understanding what you have within you as expectation is going to help you find a good target for happiness, instead for aiming for something that does not exist for you, because you're not even part of that equation really. You may be able to restructure it in a way that really fits you, and you know, those are the things I really want in my life. I want someone that loves animals because I want a dog. Instead of saying, I want a house that's perfect and white so there can be no animals. And you're ignoring part of, but I love pets. Something like that. To be happy in a relationship, you need to fight someone. And that someone is you, specifically the story in your head. Assuming different elements is a very, very big pitfall, especially in a relationship. There is an easy solution for it. Well, I say easy. The action of it is easy, but doing it sometimes is uncomfortable. It's talking to one another and speaking, sharing your fears, sharing how you feel about things, and making sure your partner understands those elements. That way they can potentially help you grow past them, because you verbalize them, yes, you're vulnerable, but at the same time you're giving yourself the opportunity to learn and grow, and see if your partner is there for you, to help you go through them. One of the questions to ask is whether or not you're afraid to speak to your partner because of your partner or because of yourself. In a lot of cases, the answer is because of myself. In some of the cases, it's because I'm afraid I'm going to be judged. I'm afraid they're not going to listen. They're not going to understand. And in those situations, it is still important to be able to talk. It's still important to be able to share. Because it's a partnership. It means two people have to work together to do something. It's not all on you or all on your partner. And this is an important aspect of things. And this will be a key tool to be able to find happiness within the relationship, to be able to have that exchange and to know where that fear comes from. Being happy in a relationship does not mean being happy all the time. This is an unattainable thing for human. By definition, we are happy because we have unhappy moments. It is the contrast that brings us joy. And it's the same thing within a relationship. A relationship will not be always the best thing ever, but that's the nature of humans. Understanding that will help you move towards being happy and enjoying the moments of happiness when they're there. That way, when they're not there, for whatever reason, maybe sometime you have to fight over something, maybe it's the both of you that have a challenge, you'll be able to work together, work through it, to try to get back to a more happy place. It's finding the time to enjoy those moments that will help you motivate yourself, fight for them, and go towards them, individually and also as a couple. It's great to have tools, it's great to know what makes you happy, to know what makes you afraid, but at the end of the day, one of the rare resources that we cannot have more of is time. If you don't have time to talk, if you don't have time to share, if you don't have time to communicate, maybe you will have a really hard time being happy in the relationship. Now, for some people, it's not very possible because they work too much, because they don't have a choice. And they have to work through that. They have to figure how to find their happiness with the card that they're dealt. And this can be very hard. This is where understanding, you know, that time resources and what makes you happy is really key. Doing that effort of understanding what you want and what you can give and sharing it with your partner will help a lot. As much as a relationship can be a fight to move forward together, to learn about yourself, to learn about one another, you should also feel support and you should feel love, and you shouldn't have to fight for this aspect. It's not because you have a fight or a quarrel, it's not because you disagree on something, that you shouldn't feel the support of your partner, that you shouldn't be loved. You shouldn't have to ask for the support and the love of your partner. Now, you may argue about, you know, what you're gonna eat tonight, and that's fine, but at the end of the day, it shouldn't change anything about why you're together and how you're gonna move forward. Whether you're gonna be able to grow together or not is another discussion, but in being happy in the relationship, you know, even if you're like, I want to eat pasta, no, I want to eat a steak, you should still be able to move past it, to talk about it, to understand things and to share. One of the big challenges is confusing being comfortable with being happy. Being comfortable does not mean you're happy, it just means you're comfortable. And understanding that difference is important. Because being comfortable means some of your buckets of needs are not being met, they're not being filled. And that can lead you to very bad ways or that can lead you to things you don't want at the end of the day, that can change your behavior towards your partner. Now, depending what it is, it can be, you know, a small aspect of your relationship or a key aspect of your relationship. Understanding that and really understanding where the happiness comes from and what are your needs is very important. Not only should you do that for yourself, but you should do the same for your partner and understand that for your partner, so you can be the one bringing what your partner requires from you. Thank you for listening to today's episode. Next week, we're gonna look at communication inside the relationship.